In this video, we're going to be looking at satellite acquisition time on the Montana 700 series. This is a follow-up from my satellite page video where I show that not only can you receive GPS satellite signals from the American GPS network, you can also receive GPS plus GLONASS, which is the Russian satellite network, and also GPS plus Galileo, which is a European one. If you look at the 60 series GPS line, I believe they have a 65 series GPS that also can receive additional satellite networks, such as the one from India in Japan. So, but this is a follow-up here. People wanted to see exactly how long it took to receive the signals when you were switching between the different setups here. So this is the 700. It has this specific satellite layout. Put down in the comments if you have a different setup here. But basically, I'm going to run a test here. I'm not going to do any cuts. I'm going to turn this on. Hasn't been used for about a week. I'm about 50 kilometers away. I'm in a park. I'm at a picnic table, and there's just the picnic table shelter above me here. So a 5x8 kind of shelter. Otherwise, it's a cloudy day. I'm going to turn this on, see how long it takes to acquire the satellite signals. And then from there, what I'm going to do is I'm going to switch between the different networks and try to get about 5 to 7 signals, and then see how long that takes here. So we're going to boot this up, and we're going to tap on the satellite page, and here we're just on the default GPS. Well, that is the American GPS satellite network. I'm here in North America. You can you'll be able to see my coordinates, so you'll be able to go on Google Maps and see where I'm at. So we see here already we have 7 signals. You can see here from the previous video, the closer the satellites are to the bullseye, the straighter up in the sky it is compared to in relation to my location, and then the ones are towards the edge are more at the horizon here. So you can see now that we received, the device has received enough signals and it is able to triangulate my position. You can see here the GPS accuracy. As it acquires more signals, this accuracy will go down, and we're going to give this another 30 seconds to kind of decide where it's at. Can see my local time up here and the UTC time down here, and the 33 meters, that's I believe that's the elevation from the last video. All right, so it looks like we're getting close to normal accuracy for my area here, which is, some days it's 3 meters accuracy, sometimes it's 8, 7. Oh, there you go, now we're down to 3. Perfect. All right, so this is we're at pretty much where I expect this device to be, and took about 30, 45 seconds or so. So now what we're gonna do here, we're going to go to the menu, and we're gonna go to the satellite setup. And here we're going to tap on satellite systems. You can see here, these are the choices I have. Based on if you have the 710i or the 750i, you may have a different setup. Because you have the inReach embedded in it, or based on the region where you bought the GPS. So let me know in the comments if there is a different list, so I'll be interested to find out. So, all right, with that, let's flip over to the Galileo, which is the European one. And let me go back. And you see here, once it's switched, we can see the Galileo section here. You can see my accuracy kind of got wonky for a second. So we'll see here how long it's going to take to start receiving some signals. And again, I'm looking how long it's going to take to get between 5 and 7. See, now our satellite accuracy is down to 3, but we've only started to receive only 2 signals at this point. You can see here on the satellite page where there are. Blue, of course, is the GPS that we started out with, and the Galileo are the green satellites. One is directly above us, and one is towards the horizon, pointing east. And we're almost about a minute or so into this. Now put down in the comments if you need to use this feature. In my location here in North America, I rely on the GPS network, so I don't really have a need to be flipping over to Galileo, which is the European one. I believe if you look at some coverage maps, my particular location, I don't think it's necessarily, I'm in a good spot to receive some signals, but we'll see here what we got. Right, so for those of you who don't know how this works with the satellite signals, this is just a receiver, right? We're just receiving radio signals. I can't remember the gigahertz range, 3 or 4 or 5. It's very similar to what cordless phones used to be back in the day. Maybe it's a different range now. But basically, this is just a receiver, right? We're receiving signals. And when we receive a signal, that signal has some, let's say they call it an almanac. That's why we see these numbers here. These numbers are not random. These are actual the satellite numbers, right? And inside of that, the signal. And inside the almanac, we have a signal. The signal also gives us basically the timetable. So one reason why some GPSs, when you turn it on, let's say running GPSs, when you do running, the first time you use that out of the box, it takes a while to acquire the signals. But the next day when you turn it on, it'll acquire the signals really quick. That's because it kind of stores the almanac on the device so that if you're in the same area, it'll take less time to find because it kind of knows which satellites are supposed to be where. I can see here, Galileo is taking a little while here. We're quite a few minutes into the Galileo acquisition time. So again, let me know your use case where you would be needing the Galileo satellite coverage here. Biggest disadvantage of using this multi-satellite network receiving is that it will drain a little bit more batteries, right? And again, we're going to see if we can get at least 5 to 7 signals from the Galileo. You can see here my default satellite network, the GPS North American one, we're adding 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Not all of them will get signal strength, but again, this probably just means that next time when I turn it on, it should be a lot quicker, but this is very interesting. Again, it's based on your area, right? There's probably some legit reasons. Maybe if you're on a boat, right? Really remote areas, kind of somewhere, some island somewhere, maybe. There's some overlap. And just a reminder, Galileo is the European GPS satellite network. You can see here that I have my Bluetooth enabled, so I'm getting my smartphone notifications. Of course, I'm recording with my iPhone at the moment, so I can't turn stuff off. And I don't want to start swiping around screens here. I want to focus on this. So we are about, 5 minutes now into the satellite acquisition. And this seems to be, the three signals here seems to be the best this is going to get. I can probably wait a little bit longer, but in terms of the video, even though I did say try to get 5 to 7 after 5 minutes of acquisition time, I indicate in the comments, is 5 minutes long enough to try to get a good satellite signal or not? Let's just give it maybe another 30 seconds and then we'll just call it here. Even though we're getting some pretty good signals here for a while now on the ones that we did acquire, I'm surprised though that we're not getting a little bit more. Oh, there we go. 4. Well, maybe we'll just hold on here for a little bit longer. Maybe you can start, maybe now we'll start coming in here. And again, you can see from the signals we have received where they fit towards the horizon or straight up. You can see how the Galileo is kind of lining up. Got one number, is it, which one is that, 7? 1 right in the middle in the bullseye, and then we got 2 pretty much here. And of course, we've got the electronic compass, so north is actually that way, obviously, east that way. So we got a few towards east, makes sense. Europe's that way. And you can see here that the accuracy has not dropped below 3, right? Consumer GPSs are inherently not as accurate as the good stuff, right? The good stuff that government uses for their markers, right? Here in Canada, there's a series of pillars or a number of installations are used to calibrate GPS, either satellites or devices, what have you. So for example, our consumer GPS devices, 3 meters is probably as good as we're gonna get. But you know, some of the high-end stuff, you're down to millimeter accuracy, you know, for some of these things. So anyway, 3 meters is really good to get in the grand scheme of things. All right, looks like we got we got 6 signals from the Galileo satellite now. So that took quite a while. So, and you can see the distribution of the satellites at this stage. So that's interesting. Let's now flip over to the next one here. We're going to do GPS plus GLONASS. And let's do that right now. Flip that over. And you can see here as it flips over, accuracy changes. And let's see how long this takes here. We're at the 14-minute mark here of the video. And already it's picking up a couple right away. Geez, are we going to get the GLONASS acquisition, the 5 to 7 birds, quicker than Galileo? Getting close to our 3 meter accuracy that we started off with. See how long it takes to get there. We're very close. We're almost ready. We're almost at our 5 to 7 threshold here. There we go. Hit 5. About a minute in, we got 3 meter accuracy. So let's see, let's give it another minute, see if we can add a couple more. So again, this is based on my location. This may be a little bit different than where you are. Be curious to know if people try this to see how long it takes to get a good signal acquisition, especially when you haven't used your GPS in a while, or you traveled a good distance so that it really needs to do a full search to try to get the acquisitions. All right, we're up to 6. And we'll do one more minute here and see how we're at. Park gates opened up about half an hour ago. People are coming in with their boats here at the park, so that's why you hear the background noise. All right, we're getting kind of close here. Maybe see if we can get one more. Oh, we almost had 6. There we go. There's another satellite right there. And I think I'm just going to give a couple more seconds here. I think we're going to call it here. It's well within our 5 to 7 satellites. You can see here, again, it doesn't necessarily improve the satellite acquisition. During this almost 20-minute video, you can see the battery strength, how it... maybe it went down, haven't really noticed, but it's something to notice here. Again, put down in the comments to see if this is a feature that you're gonna use or why you would use it. Maybe it's better if you are traveling in these regions that you can get these satellite networks. So in Europe, or if you're in Russia or India, Japan, Latin America, right, Africa, you know. Put down in the comments what you guys think. And again, if you ever wanted to access this, basically go down to the satellite setup. You can also access this through the I believe the setup menu. No, not the setup, on the main page here. Anyway, let's flip it back. All right, that's it.